immigrant child taken from family was getting her diaper changed by other children. Donald Trump finally enacted a policy so disgusting, he had to reverse it. Of course, now he's trying to gaslight the country into believing he's correcting decades of law forcing immigrant family separation. But there is a reason you've never heard of the practice of taking immigrant children at the border and putting them in cages, because it just started in April. It was Trump's policy. Related, Twitter detains Ivanka Trump for praising daddy after he fixed his own evil policy. No one with an ounce of empathy would allow it to go unspoken for long, and they didn't. And the response was so bad he gave in and stopped his policy. But it isn't over either. Trump still has no plan to put these families back together. And even if they do, these young children have been forever traumatized. We haven't gotten a good look into these facilities, but the stories we have heard are horrific. Here is just one. Michelle Brain, director of migrant rights at the Women's Refugee Commission, visited Texas Rio Grande Valley holding facility, nicknamed Ursula, because of the street it's on, not because it's villainous and tortures poor, unfortunate souls. That's just one of life's sick jokes. Brain spoke with a 16-year-old girl who had been caring for a toddler she didn't know for 3 days. The little girl's family couldn't be found, and the teen was the only one who was looking out for her, including changing her diaper apparently. Brain told the Associated Press, she had to teach other kids in the cell to change her diaper. None of the children looking after the little girl spoke her language. They guessed she was 2 years old based on her size. Eventually an attorney who was let in and saw this began asking questions and was able to locate the child's aunt. Related, woman seeking asylum from domestic abuse sues administration for taking her son. It turned out she was 4. She spoke only Kish, a language indigenous to Guatemala. Brain says the girl was inconsolable, she was so traumatized that she wasn't talking. She was just curled up in a little ball. A baby being taken care of by other babies. This is the inhumane treatment Trump, John Kelly, Sarah Huckabee Sanders, Kirstjen Nielsen, and more have been defending for weeks. This is not the law. It never was. In fact, as Brain points out, the law is very much against this kind of treatment of children. If a parent left a child in a cage with no supervision with other 5-year-olds, they'd be held accountable. Horrible. We have not heard the worst of these stories. The Border Patrol still isn't allowing cameras into these facilities. Both press and legislators have met with strong resistance trying to see what's going on in there. Video: Rachel Maddow cries while reporting on tender age shelters for migrant infants. Mark our words. We are going to hear about worse than this. These children are going to be forever scarred by this mistreatment. All because their parents were trying to bring them to what they heard was the greatest country in the world. Why is Trump's base so convinced the United States is in danger from these people? Do they think our country is so fragile that we can no longer be a land of opportunity? That we can no longer set an example for the world? Because we aren't anymore. We really are not. Image via Johnny Louis / Win / ABC News, Border Patrol via The Globe and Mail, YouTube. Tags: Donald Trump, family separation, icky icky diaper poo, icky icky poo, immigration, politic, sad, social issues, viral, kids, viral, news. Lydia Hearst is supporting, but not defending, her husband Chris Hardwick amid the fallout from his ex-girlfriend's abuse allegations. Hardwick's career has taken a bit of a nosedive in the weeks since actress and TV personality Chloe Dykstra accused an unnamed ex-boyfriend of emotional and sexual abuse. AMC pulled his show Talking with Chris Hardwick and he was fired from moderating 2 panels at San Diego Comic-Con in July. Related, Chloe thanks her supporters after Chris's denial, but Hearst, who wed the disgraced nerd icon in 2016, is sticking by his side, and attempting to do so while maintaining the importance of the #MeToo movement and believing women. In a statement to People, she explained, image via FaZe Vision / When,